Hello everyone. Extradural and subdural hematoma in the head are typically easy to distinguish from one another, but occasionally it can be difficult. In this video, we'll differentiate epidural hematoma and subdural hematoma in an easy way to understand. Just below the cranium, a few layers of membrane cover the human brain for protection. These layers are called meninges. The outer layer is called the dura mater. The middle layer is the arachnoid. It is filled with fluid to cushion the brain, while the pia mater forms the delicate inner layer. A hematoma refers to the abnormal occurrence of blood outside of its usual blood vessel. An epidural hematoma is the collection of blood in the space between the dura and the cranial bone. A subdural hematoma refers to the collection of blood between the arachnoid and dura mater. Now let's differentiate between these two types of hematomas in details. For the location, the extradural or the epidural hematoma occurs between the skull bone and the dura mater, while for the subdural hematoma, the location is between the dura and the arachnoid. The typical presentation of epidural hematoma is a young patient involved in a head trauma either during sport or as a result of a motor vehicle accident, while subdural hematoma occurs mostly in adults and are frequently due to falls and there may not be a clear history of trauma. On the pathophysiology and involved vessels, for epidural hematoma, there is rupture of the middle meningeal artery on the temporal surface of the skull, while for subdural hematoma, there is rupture of the bridging cranial veins. For clinical presentation, in epidural hematoma there will be history of trauma, mostly in a young patient. The clinical presentation of epidural hematoma is unique in that there is an associated lucid interval. This means that a patient can be conscious and appear normal right after an injury. But as the blood accumulates, the headache will worsen and mental status will decline as the intracranial pressure rises. Over the next few hours, they gradually lose consciousness. For subdural hematoma, there will be history of trauma also. Occurs more frequently in elderly patients due to reduced brain volume and stretched bridging veins. There is often history of alcohol abuse. The patient's level of consciousness gradually decreases with increasing mass effect and confusion. In young children, non-accidental injury is a significant cause. When we look at the radiological features, the epidural hematoma appears lentiform, meaning it has a biconvex shape, or it can be described as being lens-shaped or lemon-shaped. It does not cross sutures as the periosteum crosses through the suture continuous with the outer periosteal layer. For subdural hematoma, the typical presentation is a crescentic, just like the crescent shape of the moon. It can also be described as concave shape or banana-shaped appearance. It is more extensive than epidural hematoma, with the internal margin paralleling the cortical margin of the adjacent brain. And since it occurs in the subdural space, it crosses the sutures. And that's all for this video. If this video has been helpful, give us a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Until next time.